Why Hoyer?
Well, for me personally, it was it's been a 10-year journey, starting with the idea of possibly buying a watch and looking at new watches, old watches, and searched through hundreds of images online until the day I saw a Hoyer Carrera from 1966. And I knew immediately that was the watch I wanted, and I ended up buying it. I still have it, and I would never sell it. And I think for me it's the aesthetics, particularly of that watch. I think the combination of a simple, elegant dial and a magnificent case really sold me on this journey. And since then I discovered the other great Hoyer pieces of Batavia and Monaco and others. There's just a real depth for a collector to find as many, lots and lots of pieces, because as collectors we want to have as many as we can. But there's a real array of watches. Now, I've always focused on the Jack Hoyer period, so there were from 63 till 86 a vast number of pieces for me to collect, and I sure found plenty.
I gather that you both met through your passion of Hoyer. You've got a funny anecdote about that.
Yeah, well, myself and Paul actually bid on a watch on eBay, the first watch that I bought, and what happened was that we agreed, unbeknownst to us, we both agreed to buy a watch from Thailand, and we basically found it on eBay, and guy persuaded us to bank wire some money, and the watch never came. I went into the forum, Jeff Stein's on the dash, and I bemoaned about the fact and warned people not to buy anything from this guy. And then Paul posted the same day and said, "Oh my God, I've just bought the same watch. It's not going to come, is it?" And I went, "It's not going to come." So we then met and had lunch, and from there on, that's how we started, really.
People here tonight who have also participated in the scholarship of Hoyer. You mentioned Jeff Stein. We also have Arnold Haslinger. It really is a brand that's brought together a whole community.
There is a massive community, and it's a very strong and tight community, and we are very passionate collectors, and from the auction or generally?
Generally? I'm guessing it's one from the auction though.
Yeah. If I could take a piece away tonight and pay the 25% fee to take it back, it would be the Screwback Case GMT. Yeah.
My grandfather started it, and my father continued, and I also continued. We gave the watches a name. All our watches have a name. And the people don't even say the brand, they just said Otavia or Carrera or whatever it is. And I was rallying with my little MGA I had. I wanted to rally to see how our dashboard watches were used. And so I mounted a Master Time and an Otavia on the dashboard and went out rallying with a friend. But we didn't do so well because he was not good at reading the map. So I had learned reading the map in the Boy Scouts and in the Army, and so I said, the next time I will do the map reading. So we did a second rally, and we came in right on track, perfect, everything was, except I misread a minute on the dashboard Otavia, and we didn't win because of this 1 minute, and because that bloody dial was so badly designed that you would easily make a minute error in a shaking car. So that's why I said this Otavia, no good.